Greetings. This is Pastor Linda with Arise and Shine Group. We are going live tonight. Tonight we're doing a corporate prayer, and I'm not sure who's joining me tonight, but I encourage you, if you have prayer requests, please message me, or you can let me know by just putting them in the comments below. You can message me. It looks like we're live right now, so please feel free. Again, we're talking about prayer tonight. The Bible says, confess your faults, your trespasses one to another. And it says, pray for one another that you may be healed. The effective, fervent prayer of a righteous man avails much. That's in James 5. You can see it right behind me. James 5, 17. All right, looks like I have Jody's coming to join me tonight. Hello, Jody. Hey, Jody, how's it going? Good to see you. Can you hear me?
There, I can now. Yes, I have that too. I have another meeting right away, but also, you guys are an hour ahead of us. I can be with you for 45 minutes.
Oh, good, good, good. Praise God. Well, welcome. It's been a while since I've seen and heard from you.
Oh, life is crazy. How are you doing, though?
Good, good, good. Yeah, we had a great service on Resurrection Sunday, and we ordained Servando and Liliana to the pastors for the Spanish ministry in their new church, Spanish church. So, yeah, it's exciting. And, so I see you're expanding your ministry home there.
Yes.
That's good. Praise God.
Caleb took his last load of stuff out on Friday, and Jordan said, I need to put it out there that we have some empty rooms, and boom, right? So it is. Amen. I mean, what we pray is that Adrian, this young father, will really find out who Jesus really is as far as his higher power and the journey to stay clean and sober. But yeah, God knows what he's doing. I sure don't.
Yeah. Amen. 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 That's where we have to trust the Lord to do that. We can share Jesus with them, but the Holy Spirit has to minister to them, and they have to receive it, you know? Amen. So, amen. Well, tonight we're going to do prayer. So, you know what? Before we get started, though, I'd like to do some worship songs. You have some worship songs in mind? You always have worship songs. Well, think about it for a minute. You know, we'll say hi to Joy Wubu. Joy, how you doing?
Hi, good. And you?
Good, good. Good to see you. Welcome tonight to Rise and Shine. And Jody Faith is all the way from Canada. Jody's an international singer, and we traveled together to Israel and Norway, and did television together. That was awesome fun. And then, so if you come up with a song, I want to do some prayer and praise before we get started with the prayer. I want to do some praise and thanksgiving. And Joy's a nurse from Minnesota here. She's just down the road from me, not too far. So appreciate you, Joy. She's such a blessing at our church. She's an intercessor, and they're always to help anything that I need help with. She's just a blessing. So I appreciate that, Joy.
Thank you. Appreciate the opportunity.
Amen. God is good. Amen. So tonight, what I want to do is I want to read some scriptures here from, we're looking at, let me go here to.
Have you started recording already?
Oh, you know what? I haven't. Thank you for reminding me to do that.
Hi, Jody.
How are you, Joy?
I'm good. And you?
Good.
Good to see you again.
Yes, nice to see you. I think of you often.
Thank you.
Get to be here. And I have a meeting. I have another meeting in less than an hour. And I thought, no, but I could come on for a little while. So I'll.
All right. So it looks like, let me see, Chrissy had a. Chrissy said she'll be on in a minute. So, okay. So. If anybody has any prayer requests, I'm just requesting people to put it out there tonight, because we're going to pray for the need. So if anybody has any prayer requests, just message me, or you put it in the notes. If somebody can look on their Facebook page in case I miss something. let me just know about it. All right, so I'm going to go to the scriptures that I had out here. Looks like somebody just messaged me. All right, so tonight before we get started, we want to just do some talking about some scriptures tonight about Thanksgiving. You know, there's one in particular I was wanting to look at in Philippians. It says, "Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God." So when we come to God, we're not to be anxious or worried, but in everything by prayer and supplication. So that just means presenting it before God in prayer and with a sincere heart, with thanksgiving, let a request be made known unto God. So we need to give thanks tonight. So that's what I want to start off with some thanksgiving. And then, you know, it says in Psalms 147:7, it says, "Sing unto the Lord with thanksgiving. Sing praises on the harp to our God." So we're to sing praises. I don't know if you know that one, Jody. Sing praises unto God, sing praises. Sing praises unto God, sing praises. You don't know that one?
I don't.
All right. And then enter his gates with thanksgiving. I bet you know that one.
I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say, "This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice in."
For he has made me glad.
Right?
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. It says Psalms 95:2, "Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving. Let us shout joyful to him with psalms." So we're to come into his presence with thanksgiving and shout joyfully to him with psalms. So it's okay to be loud when we sing. He said, "I will praise the name of God with a song, and I will magnify him with thanksgiving." And then in the New Testament, it says we're to be rooted and built up in him and established in faith as you've been taught, abounding in it with thanksgiving. Earnestly, it says, continue earnestly in prayer, be vigilant in it with thanksgiving. So as we praise and thanks, give God thanks tonight, we want to do it with thanksgiving in our heart. So, all right, so we're going to do that. I'm going to take it off sharing tonight. So we're going to get started. So I just want, if there's any requests out there, if you have any requests, please let us know. And Jody, are you on Facebook right now?
I can't. I just tried there. And I'm not finding the feed.
Okay. I did message you on it, or tagged you in it. Yeah.
Yeah. See, I always have trouble getting on. I don't know why. So.
Okay.
Here. I actually sent the link to myself on Facebook again, just so I could try to get on. No, there's nothing there. So I don't know where they go.
Okay. Cause it says we're live on Facebook. Let me just look at my other, computer here. All right. Well, we'll just get started. And then if you do have prayer requests, we'll be able to check them. If you could just message me or, let me look and see on Facebook here. I'm on live right now. See if it's coming up. Oh, there's Chris. Hey, Chrissy, are you there? Oh, she said she's having issues getting on. Hey, Chrissy, you made it. All right. Looks like we are on. So I can see us on online there. So, okay. All right. So let's get started tonight. So I just want to go ahead and we're going to start off with just praise and thanksgiving. And if you have any prayer or thanksgivings you'd like to, pray and give God thanks, then let me know. Just go ahead and pray it out. And then we want to just get started. We're going to pray for our nation. We want to pray for our, the churches. We want to pray for a revival and so many things. I've got a list of things here that we can pray for. So, and if you have things that you'd like to pray for, please put them, please go ahead and pray for them. And then like I said, in comments, if people have prayer, I'm just going to put it. If you have a prayer request, please type here. All right. So there we go. All right. Well, let's just begin. All right. Father, we just thank you tonight for your goodness, Lord. We just praise you and thank you for all of the good things that you've done for us, Lord. You are a good God. Lord, you're high and lifted up and your train fills the temple, Lord. We thank you, God, that you are the all-sufficient God. You are El Shaddai, our all-sufficient one, Jehovah Jireh, our provider, Jehovah Rapha, our healer, Jehovah Shalom, our peace. Lord, you are the great I am. Lord, you're the King of kings and the mighty God, the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Lord, you are the shepherd of the sheep. Lord, you're the lily of the valley, the Prince of Peace. Lord, almighty God, everlasting Father, we look to you, Lord, tonight. Lord God Almighty, we praise you and thank you, God. You're high and lifted up, and we just exalt you today. We thank you that you're on the throne, and we worship you and praise you with thanksgiving in our heart. And Lord, we thank you we can enter into your courts with praise and be thankful unto you and bless your holy name, Lord. Lord, we know that, Lord, that you hear our prayers. Lord, you said the effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man, Lord, or woman, prevails much. And so, Lord, we thank you that our prayers prevailing much. And Lord, you said in the book of Revelation, Lord, you said that that you're putting those our prayers, requests that come up before you, God, you're putting them in a vial, a censer. And Lord, you said you're going to be throwing them back to the earth, Lord, with thundering and lightning, Lord God. And I thank you that, Lord, that they're effectual, they're mighty. And so we thank you for just the mighty works that you're going to do in the earth and through us and through your church, Lord. So we pray that your church would arise in the earth and shine and become that bright light in the darkness and be salty in the earth, Lord God. We pray that your church would arise in their authority and power. You said, whatever we bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatever we loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven and on earth, Lord. So we thank you. That means to allow and forbid. So, Lord, we just forbid the wicked and evil in our government and in our lives and our families' lives in Jesus' name from operating against us. And Lord, we allow your angels to minister on our behalf. We allow your Holy Spirit to teach us. We allow your word just to go forth, Father God, in power and might and demonstration. We thank you that the angels hearken unto the voice of your word today. And Lord, we are the voice in the earth. We are your body. We are your mouth. We are your hands and feet. So Lord, let your church arise and become that mighty bright light in the darkness and in the government and in Canada and in the United States and around the world, Lord. Wherever your church is, God, may they arise and shine. For the light has come and the glory of the Lord has risen upon us. Lord, you said great darkness would come upon the earth, but your glory will arise upon us, Lord, your church. So we just believe for that in Jesus' name. So Lord, have your way tonight as we continue to pray. We just give you honor and grace and thanksgiving. So if you have something to either praise or thanksgiving, just pray it out and thank God.
Yeah, I'm thankful, Father God, that you are the God of provision, that you are the God of provision, that you know our needs. And financially, we had some miracles here at our house just in the last week, Father God, with unexpected gifts to the expenses here at the house. Father, I just thank you that we can cry out to you. I was asked by a pastor, encouraged perhaps to just fast and pray as I asked in agreement, you know, with the things that we needed here, asking others to agree with me, Father. There was such unity in the agreement. And so I just thank you that in the midst of our kind of chaotic world, when we don't know what's happening, dear Lord, that you come through for us. We need to remember these testimonies of those times when you have been there. You have shown up in a mighty way so that we can be encouraged. So Father, I just ask that our faith would be sort of stirred up in a beautiful way, that supernatural faith, Father, that you can do all things and that you do these things. You are our provider, Father God. Thank you that we've just celebrated Easter, and we know that most important gift you've ever given is the sacrifice of your son, that we would be provided for, that we would be given a free pass, if you will, to spend eternity. We don't have to pay for eternity for the sins that we've done and the ways that we've let you down, for the ways that we've failed, for the regrets and shames. But instead, Father, we are forgiven.
Yes,
absolutely,
thank you, Lord.
Completely forgiven. When I think of you as my provider, I just thank you for that provision of forgiveness and grace and mercy, Father. Just that you are such a giving God, that you are the God of all good things. And we just praise you for that in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah, yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Go ahead.
Father, we thank you so much that your mercy is new every morning. Father, we thank you for your love towards us. Thank you that you have called us your own. Thank you that we are accepted in the beloved. Thank you that you have we are highly favored by you. You say with favor, you will surround us as a shield. Father, we receive who you are in us, all that you have done in our life. And we just give you thank you. We give you praise and honor. We thank you, Father, for your goodness, Lord. You are good, Lord. You are a good God, Father. Thank you for calling us your own, Father. Thank you that that's exactly who we are, Father. Your word says, Father, in Romans chapter 8, verse 1, that there is therefore now no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus. So, Father, we thank you that there is no condemnation, that we are your child and you have called us your own. Thank you for who we are in you, Father God. Thank you, Lord. We just thank you for being our Father, for being our Lord. Thank you that we are your child, Lord. We just give you praise and honor for that, Father.
Hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, we praise you, God. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness to us tonight, Lord. And, you know, we just thank you, God, that, Lord, that you are high and lifted up tonight, Lord God. And we just thank you that you are the great I am. And we look to you tonight. And, you know, I thank you that you hear our prayers, Lord, and that the effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man is tremendous in its power, dynamic in its working. And you hear our prayers, Lord. And so, Lord, we just lift up, Lord, our nation to you, God, and we lift up Canada before you, God. We just pray, God, for any evil or wicked people that are influencing the government or in the government, Lord, we just pray that you remove them and replace them, Lord God, with godly people, people that will rise and shine, and Lord, that righteousness, justice, and truth will prevail. Lord God, we pray that you'd expose the darkness, Lord, and just shine in your light in all of the evil and Lord, the thing that's going on in the world. Father, we pray for the child and sex trafficking, Lord, that's going on. We pray, God, that you would just, Lord God, protect the children, save the children, expose the darkness, Lord, expose those who are having, Lord, involved in any evil or wickedness, Lord. We just thank you, God, that your church is the light in the darkness. So let your church arise, Lord. Let your church, Lord, exercise its dominion and its authority that we have in the name of Jesus, Lord. So let your church arise, Father God, and be that bright light in the darkness, shining, Lord, salty, flavorful, Father God, in Jesus' name. So we thank you, God. We thank you for a mighty outpouring of your spirit upon our nation. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we just pray, God, that for righteousness, justice, and truth to prevail, Lord God. Lord, you said in Timothy to pray, first of all, for those who are in leadership, Lord, in our nation, Lord God. So we do pray that we would continue to be able to live a peaceful and godly life in Christ Jesus, so we can preach the gospel, Lord. So we just pray, God, for righteousness, justice, and truth, Lord, for godly leaders, so that we can continue to preach the gospel, Lord. We pray for laborers into the harvest, Lord. You said to pray you that the Lord of harvest would send laborers into the harvest. So we pray, God, for laborers, Lord. We pray that you would just lift up and bring laborers into the harvest, Father God. We just thank you, God, that you've given us authority and power in the name of Jesus, Lord. We thank you forgiving us the spirit of wisdom and revelation, the knowledge of you, Lord God. We just pray for understanding, counsel, might, Lord. And we thank you for the knowledge and the fear of the Lord. We thank you for prophetic insight into what you're doing today, God. We thank you that you give us the ability to hear you clearly, Lord God. You give us insight into, Lord, witty ideas and creative inventions, Lord God, to be able to be effective and profitable in your kingdom, Father God, and in your church, Lord. Lord, we just thank you that you open our ears and we just thank you that your word is at work within us, Lord. Lord, inspiring us to righteousness and justice and truth, Lord God. We pray that for our nation, that righteousness, justice, and the truth, and for our own lives, Father God, for our churches, for our communities, Lord God, for our local leaders, Father God. We pray that you to raise up local godly leaders, Lord. We pray for righteousness, justice, and truth to prevail. Father, we thank you for, we hear, you said, my sheep hear my voice and they know me, Lord. So we thank you for clear, crisp transmission. So we thank you, Lord, that we can receive and download, Father God, from your infinite resource library in the heavens, Lord. We thank you that we can download from your resources, Lord, the spirit of wisdom and revelation, the knowledge of you, Lord God. You said that that the eyes of our understanding would be enlightened so that we would know the hope to which you've called us, that we would know the exceeding greatness of your power towards us, that we would know, the glory and the power of your church today, Lord Jesus, that we would walk in it in the name of Jesus. So, Lord, cause our spiritual eyes to function and have 20/20 vision, Lord God. Clarity and insight, Lord, understanding and interpretations of the times and the movements of your Holy Spirit, God. I thank you, Lord God, that you, Lord, that you lead us along the paths of righteousness, Lord, for your name's sake, Lord God. I thank you, Lord, that we are living in, Lord, your perfect will, Father God. You said in Romans 12 that I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that we present our bodies to you as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable, which is our reasonable service, Lord. So we present our bodies to you right now as a living sacrifice, God. And we thank you, God. We just present it to you and we say, use us today. Use my body. Use me, Lord Jesus. I present my will to you, my soul to you, my mind, will, and emotions, Lord God. And I just present it to you and I say, use me, Lord God. And Lord, you said, don't be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of our mind so that we can prove your good and your acceptable and your perfect will in our lives, Lord. Lord, so I pray that your perfect will would be done in our lives, God, today, that our minds would be renewed, Lord. I pray that you prosper our souls today, our mind, will, and emotions, Lord God. And 3 John 2, you said, beloved, I wish above all things that you may prosper and be in health as your soul prospers. So I pray that our souls would prosper. I pray for our nation, God. I pray for the people. I pray for your church, Lord, to rise up and that their souls would prosper, Lord God, that we would get the mind of Christ, that we would hold the feelings and thoughts and intents of Jesus' heart in our heart, Lord God. So Lord, have your way, Holy Spirit in our lives, Lord. We thank you, God, for Lord, your supernatural power, Holy Spirit power moving in through us today, Lord. I thank you for your anointing that's upon us, Lord, that we are more than conquerors. We are warriors in Christ, Lord God. We have the whole armor of God on, the helmet of salvation. We have the breastplate of righteousness, Lord. We have girded our loins with the truth, Lord. We shod our feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace, Lord. We have the shield of faith, Lord. We have the breastplate of righteousness, Lord. We've taken the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, Lord. And we speak forth the word of God tonight. And we just put on your whole armor, God. And we stand on your covenant promises, the blood covenant, Lord God. Thank you for you're the God of the covenant, a better covenant, a new covenant, Lord God. It's a better promises, Lord God, and then the Old Testament covenant. So we stand upon your covenant promises today. Lord, we thank you, God, for the healing of our bodies. You said by your stripes we were healed. Lord God, you sent your word and healed us and delivered us in Psalm 107:20. And so we just claim healing for our bodies right now. Anybody out there that's watching tonight that needs healing, we claim healing, Lord, in Jesus' name. You sent your word and healed us and delivered us from destruction. And so I thank you, God. Anybody that's going through any destruction tonight, Lord God, I just lift up Jody before you right now. Jody from that was asking for prayer today, Lord God. We just ask right now in Jesus' name for healing of her body in the name of Jesus. I just speak to you, Jody, and I just call you healed in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you from the top of her head to tips of her toes, Lord God. You sent your word and healed her, Lord. So just thank you for manifesting healing to her, Lord. And in Romans 8, Lord, you said, Lord, the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in us and will quicken our mortal bodies. So thank you for quickening her immune system, her mortal body in Jesus' name with your healing virtue, Lord. And 1 Peter 2:24, it says, by your stripes, she was healed. So we just claim that in Jesus' name. So we thank you, God. And we thank you for your hedge of protection that you surround us, all of our family members, Lord. We just thank you, God, for our families. We just present our children to you, our grandchildren, great-grandchildren, Lord. We thank you, God, for all of our family members, Lord. We just present them to you, God. We thank you for Psalms 91. You give your angel special charge over them that no evil befall them, Lord. You said that you would bear them up in the angel's hands unless they dash their foot against a stone, Father God. We thank you that you protect them. You sent your word to heal them, Lord, in Jesus' name. And Lord, you give your angels special charge over them that no evil will fall them. So we just thank you, God. We send out your angels. They hearken unto the voice of your word, you said in Psalms 103. So we claim that in the name of Jesus. Thank you, God, that they're hearkening into the voice of your word and of your name in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We thank you, God, that Lord, that your divine will and your divine word is being accomplished. Lord, you said, let's just pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Lord, we thank you, God, that you are the kingdom, the power and the glory forever and ever, Lord. We just thank you for your promises in your word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, the word hallowed is in this is coming from the prayers that prevail much. It says the word hallowed is best defined by its synonyms: holy, consecrated, revered, and sacred. In his model prayer, Jesus expressed his reverence for his Father by giving special regard to his names. The names of God in the Bible reveal his attributes. They tell of us many important things about his nature. By reflecting on the names of God, as Jesus did in the Lord's Prayer, we are reminded of who God is, how he works in our lives, and the blessings he has promised to impart to his children. In Psalms 91, it says, and those who honored him and know his name, to those he will satisfy and show their salvation, or he will satisfy them with long life and show them his salvation. So knowing his name is so important. And what is his name? Well, this is just a review of his names. It says Yahweh, Jehovah, the God who always is and never changes. So we can have confidence that God never changes. Amen. And then Adonai, the Lord who is eternal. God never changes. Amen. And he's Jehovah Elohim, the majestic Lord who is worthy of worship. And he's Jehovah Elohim, the Lord God Most High. He's El Shaddai, the Almighty God. Jehovah Jireh, our provider. Jehovah Rapha, our healer. Jehovah Tsidkenu, our righteousness. Jehovah Nissi, our conqueror. Jehovah Shalom, our peace. Jehovah Shammah, the God who is there. Oh, there's Chris. He must have dropped off here. Hey there, Chris, are you there? Hey, Chris, are you back? Can you hear me? Are you there?
Yes.
Oh, good.
Can you hear me?
Okay. Yep, I can.
Oh, good. Yeah. Hi, hon. How are you?
Good. Are you?
Good. Sorry, I had to reset my modem.
Oh, okay. No problem. No problem.
Router.
Okay. Well, I was just reading a. I think she's there. Maybe she just
stepped away for a moment.
Yeah, she said she's got another call to be on, but so she said she'd be with us for a little while. Okay. So Jehovah Shammah is the God who is there. Jehovah Shalom is our peace. Jehovah Nissi is the God, our conqueror. This is all names in the Old Testament. And Jehovah Rohi, he's our shepherd. And Jehovah Olam is the everlasting one. So these names reveal who he is to us. In hallowing his names in prayer, we are expressing faith to the Father. We see him as all his power. He will provide, he will heal. He's our shepherd, he will guide us. He has imparted his peace, his righteousness, his sanctification to us. He's our conqueror who has defeated the enemy. He is always there. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. So hallelujah. So some of the other things I just like to pray for tonight is the Harvest Project. We just want to reach out to disciple and to get mentor more people to do the work of the ministry. We need some sound equipment and help with that. And then we're having a youth event coming up. So I just really want the power of God, the Holy Spirit, to just be present there.
Amen.
Also for just health and healing for, church and family members and just protection over them. We're going to have an upcoming evangelistic service. So outreaching to the community and for our new Spanish ministry, we just ordained Servando and Lily. So we want to make sure that that's continuing on. So if you guys would like to help pray for that, Joy.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Father, we just thank you so much for your faithfulness. Father, you say that what two or three people, what we bound on earth will be bound in heaven, and what we lose on earth should be lost in heaven. Father, you say that where there's two or three people gathered in your name, you are in their midst. Father, I thank you that there is no distance in the realm of the spirit. Even though we're in a separate places, you are still in our midst even now. So Father, we thank you. We thank you so much that you always answer prayer. You are faithful to your word, Father God.
Yeah,
and so we put you in remembrance of your word, Father. You said in Matthew chapter 6, Father, that we are the salt of the light. We are the salt of the world and the light, Father. We are the light of the world. Mm-hmm. And so, Father, I just ask that you would make our life make us to be thirsty as we go out in the world, in our workplaces, wherever we go, that our life will cause people around us to thirst and just say there's something about them. I don't know what it is, but whatever it is, I want it. And so Father, especially I pray that for the youth, Father God, the youth that are coming in to live in hope, Father, I pray that that their life will be like a magnet, Father. There will be something in their life that their light will shine so bright that when other people come around them, they will long and yearn for your presence in their life. They will say there's something about this kids that I want, Father. And so I pray for our youth.
Amen.
That you will make their life to thirst. You will make them, their light should shine bright and their life to cause people around them to thirst for you, Father. And I pray for boldness. Father, you said that the righteous shall be as bold as a lion. I pray for this youth, Father God, that their life will be so bold for you, Father, that they will not allow anything around them to cause them to fear, Father, that they will walk in boldness, Father God. And that boldness again will be a magnet and something that will cause other people around them to say, I want what you have. And so, Father, we ask for that. I pray that this event will go so well that you will draw many other youth to come for this event, Father, and that it will be a time of them to be refreshed and receive from you as well as have fun, Father. We pray for that. Father, we lift all the members at church before you, the ones that are not feeling well. Father, we speak healing over anyone that is not feeling well right now. I thank you, Jesus, that you have sent your word and you have healed them. I thank you, Father God, that you said in your word in Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 17, you said that you will restore health to them and you will heal them, Father. And so, Father, we speak healing and restoration of their health. Whatever is going on in their body, Father, we take authority against that illness. We command it to go and we speak healing and restoration over their body, even now in Jesus' name. We take authority against any diabetes, any kidney stone, any heart problem, any pain, any back pain, knee pain, arthritis. Father, we bound any of these symptoms, any of these sicknesses, and we speak healing over their bodies, yes, even right now in Jesus' name. Thank you. By your stripes, they are healed. And we stand in your word and authority in your word. And we stand in that finished work that is done. And we receive that healing even right now, Father, in Jesus' name.
Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. And Ruth has asked us to pray for her brother who has some health issues and needs to find a doctor that can help him. So, Lord, we just thank you, God. Lord, and we just thank you that mostly, Lord Jesus, that he opens his heart to find you, Jesus, because you're the great physician, Lord. And we thank you that, Lord, you bore his sickness and pains, and by stripes he is healed. So we just thank you, God, for supernatural manifestation, Lord. We just pray that the Holy Spirit would just draw him unto Jesus. We pray that his heart would be open, that his eyes of his understanding would be flooded with light, and he would know the hope to which you called him. We just bind the blinding spirits that are upon his mind, Lord, God. And Lord, you said, Lord, just pray that the eyes of their understanding are enlightened, that they know the hope to which you've called them, that they know the exceeding greatness of your power towards them, that they know the riches of the glory of their inheritance in you, Jesus, in Ephesians 1. So we just pray that prayer for him, God, that he would have a spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of you, God. Flood his heart with light, Lord. May he know the life of Jesus, the love of Jesus, and the light of God. Flood his heart with light, Lord Jesus. And we thank you for healing, Lord God, that you are the great healer, Lord. We thank you for just, Lord, helping him, whatever his health issues are, you know what they are, Lord God, that you'll help him fight. Father, show him the root cause, Lord, let them know the root cause of it, Lord, and help him to deal with the root cause of it, whatever it is, Lord, whether it be physical, emotional, Lord, spiritual, Lord God, we just thank you that you show him the root cause, and Lord, to help him how to deal with it, Lord, whether it be naturally, spiritually, physically, Lord God, we just thank you, God, that are emotionally, Lord, we just thank you that you sent your word and healed them. And 3 John 2, you said, beloved, I wish above all things that you may prosper and be in health, even as your soul, your mind, will, and emotions prosper. So we pray that his mind, will, and emotions prosper, that he can be healed whole in every year of his life, Lord. You sent your word and healed him and delivered him. And you said that chastisement, the correction of our peace, was upon you, and with your stripes we were healed. So not only can he have physical healing, but he can have an emotional healing as well, Lord God. So we thank you for emotional healing and peace, peace of mind, peace of heart, Lord, and his whole body. And Lord, in Thessalonians, it says, I pray, God, I think it's 1 Thessalonians 5:23. I pray, God, that your whole spirit, soul, and body may be preserved blameless until the coming of the Lord. So we pray that for Ruth's brother in Jesus' name. Thank you, God. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Lord. We thank you for what you're doing and the power of your spirit. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus. If you have prayers out there, other prayer requests, please let us know so we can pray tonight. Anything special, Chrissy, do you have anything special you want prayer for, or Joy or Jody?
My daughter, Megan, had COVID a while ago, but she still only has 10% of her smell back. So, need to pray for that to be restored.
Amen. Well, let's pray. Father, we thank you for restoration of, her smell and her taste, Lord God. And Lord Jesus, help her to get to the root of that, Lord God, whether it's natural, Lord God, maybe that she's something, Lord, lacking naturally or whatever it is. Father, we just thank you that you sent your word and healed her and delivered her, and her immune system, just restore her immune system back to 100% in Jesus' name.
Yes,
we thank you, God, in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Father, I just thank you, your word in John chapter 10, verse 10. He said that you've come to give us life, life more abundantly. And we speak abundant life over Jody's daughter right now. We command every senses to be restored back to normal the way you created them to be in Jesus' name. Father, you say that you will restore us to health and you will heal us of our wounds in Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 17. And so, Father, as Pastor Linda prayed, and we in total agreement. And so we speak complete restoration of her senses, that she will be able to smell like she was before in Jesus' name. Yes, so thank you for complete healing and restoration over her body, Lord, even now. In Jesus' name, we speak that abundant life over her body right now
Yes, Lord, you said if two or more agree as touching anything, it shall be done of our Father which is in heaven. So Lord, we just agree in Jesus' name that it's done in the name of Jesus, Lord. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Joy, thank you. And also Ruth, before I forget, Ruth, the one who asked for prayer for her brother, also goes for a test that God knows of, that I just pray next week that all will be fine and good and be in whole, healthy, and completely lacking in nothing.
Amen. Why don't you go ahead and pray? We'll just agree with you.
So Heavenly Father, we just thank you, Lord, for your healing powers. We just thank you, Lord, for your loving kindness. We just thank you, Lord, that you hear us or hear us in heaven, Lord, when we pray with a sincere heart, Lord. And you said, like Linda said, wherever two or more are gathered, there you are in the midst of us. We may not be there physically, Lord, but we are connected via online, Lord. And we just thank you for hearing our prayers for all those who need healing, Lord. And I just pray for Ruthie's test results, that they will come back clean and that she'll be whole, healthy, and complete, lacking in nothing, Lord. And we just thank you for that in advance, Lord. Just thank you for your healing of all those who need healing, Lord. I pray that you heal my knee, Lord, my right knee and my right wrist, Lord God. And I just thank you for that healing now in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. We just thank you for Chrissy, which agree that by the stripes of Jesus, she's healed. And Lord, her body is functioning the perfection which you created to function, Lord. And Lord, you just, Lord, just heal. Healing and wholeness are hers in Jesus' name. We thank you, Father, for that. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. We thank you, God, for your Holy Spirit power. We thank you, God, that that you're at work within us tonight. And Lord God, all those who are watching, we pray whatever their needs are. We just thank you that there's no distance in the Spirit. Lord, that you just send forth your word to them and heal them wherever they're at. Lord Jesus, we thank you, God, for Sandy, that you thank you for blessing her business and everything she puts her hands to, Lord God, tonight. We ask that you just minister to her and through her in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we just thank you for Jackie and just ministering to her and blessing her as well. And Lord, anyone else, Lord God, that's been a part of our groups, Lord God, we just thank you. Sent your word and healed them and delivered them in Jesus' name, Lord. We just thank you for the name of Jesus. That's above every other name, Lord God. And we thank you, God, that, Lord, that you hear our prayers, Lord God. We thank you that, Lord, we pray for salvation. I think we need to pray for our family members that are not saved. If you have a family member out there, if you're listening, if you're not saved, tonight's the day. The Bible says today is the day of salvation. You can know Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You have to.
Yes.
Just to know him is just call upon the name of the Lord and you will be saved, just with a sincere heart, like Chrissy said, just with your heart of faith. Just say, God, I believe that you sent Jesus to die on the cross for my sin. I believe that he was raised from the dead so that I could have life, that he took my sin upon the cross and my sickness, my pains. He took everything and he took it and he paid the penalty for all my sin. And he went to hell, got back the keys of death and hell, and rose again from the dead. And because he resurrected and he's at the right hand of the Father, he's interceding for us. Because he lives, we can live. And because he shed his blood and was the atonement for our sin, he paid the penalty. You can be free from sin. You be forgiven and washed clean. So tonight, Father, I pray for all those who are watching. If they don't know you, Jesus, that they'll cry out to you and just say, Jesus, save me. I'm sorry for my sin. Forgive me. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness. Give, make me new. Bible says, if you confess Jesus, your Lord, you'll become born of the Spirit and you'll be a new creation and created in God's image and likeness. You were created like that. And then Adam and Eve sinned. But then Jesus came and the second Adam and redeemed us back to himself. So Lord, we just thank you for all those watching. May they know the depth and the the length and the depth and the breadth and the height of your love for them, Lord. You sent Jesus, your only begotten Son, into the world, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. He was willing to send his Son to you because he loves you. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So go ahead if you have any other prayer requests or anything you'd like to pray.
I was just inspired there when you were praying for Jackie. Just, we have this new fellow here. His name is Adrian. Father, I just praise you that you've been able to work in lives that were, where kids were actually taken from their parents, and you're restoring their lives so that they are being allowed not only to see their kids, but to actually be the sole caregiver for them, Father God. That's just such a perfect example of the resurrection power, the restoration power. And so, Father, we just ask that for the hurting families in our world today, that they would just turn to you, that they would see you as the restorer of relationships. We thank you, Father God, that you're there to help them put back the pieces of broken lives, that you are the caregiver, that you are the one true living God who wants to see them restored and in health. And Father, we just come against the addictions. We come against the drug and alcohol, rampant drug and alcohol use that's going on, especially since COVID, where people are just finding so much hopelessness, Father God. We just ask that they would find their peace, that they would find their joy, that they would find what they need in you, Father God, not in the things of this world, but in you, that they would be free and delivered from their addictions in Jesus' name, that they would be able to have a testimony of healing, that the world would hear that there is so much more after drugs and alcohol, Father. And we just thank you for these testimonies that we have, even in our immediate circle, of these kids that are just coming back and being restored in their families. Yes, and we ask for these single parents, that they would not be weary, that you would give them the strength that they need to be the parents that they want to be, that they fought for the right to be, Father God, that they would just know that they know that they don't have to do it alone, that you are there to strengthen them, and that your joy will strengthen them. And Father, what a beautiful place to be in the bliss and the joy that you give us, because we have been redeemed by you.
Hallelujah. Yes,
let them know that.
Hallelujah. 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 You know, the song that comes to me is that Something Beautiful. Remember you were singing that one?
Something beautiful. That one?
Amen. Yeah, sing it. Can you sing it?
Something good. All my confusion, you understood. All I had, I don't know what I had. Nothing
to offer, for you. To offer him was brokenness.
All I had to offer him was brokenness and strife. But you made something beautiful of my life. Oh, that's
amen.
Good.
Isn't that the truth? That is so good. Amen. You know, I just feel like, Jody, when as you're singing that and as you said that, you know, there are so many people out there watching tonight too, that you may have come from a broken home. You may have come from, like you said, like Jody said, you may have come from a place where you were, maybe you were put up for adoption, or maybe you were in a foster home, or maybe you just don't have parents and you don't feel like you belong. But I want you to know tonight that you are loved, that the Father loves you with an everlasting love. His ban over you is love, and that your value is the precious blood of Jesus. You are created in God's image and likeness, and he wants you to know that when you come to him, he'll wash you clean as white as snow. The Bible says, as far as the east is from the west, he'll remember your sins no more. He'll make you white as snow. And so tonight you can receive that, and there's, he'll take away the shame and the pain, and he'll give you life. And I just want to read a few things here too. This is from Commanding Your Morning by Cindy Trim. This is some of the things that you can have in Jesus' name. In Jesus, you can, that you are a son of God. You are saved by grace. You are born of an incorruptible seed. You've redeemed by the blood. You're forgiven of all of your sins. You're a new creation in Christ. You're redeemed from the curse of the law. You're beloved of God. You're seated in heavenly places with Christ Jesus. You are a member of a chosen generation. You're an ambassador for Christ. You're the light of the world. You're a citizen of the kingdom of heaven. You're joint heir with Jesus. You're accepted in the beloved. You're complete in him. You're crucified with Christ. You're alive with Christ. Hallelujah. You're reconciled to God. You're justified by faith. You're a significant contributing member of the body of Christ. You're the temple of the Holy Spirit. You're the salt of the earth. You're the bride of Christ. You're sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise. You're the elect of God, established by grace, drawn near to the God by the blood of Christ. You're victorious through Christ. You're purposely built and uniquely designed for success. You're set free. You're a disciple of Christ. You're a visionary. You're the head and not the tail. You're above and not beneath. You're first and not last. You're strong in the Lord. You're more than a conqueror. You're rooted and built up and established in the faith. You're abounding in the spirit of thanksgiving. You're the righteousness of God. You're partakers of his divine natures. You're called of God. You're fearfully and wonderfully made. You're the apple of your father's eye. You're healed by the stripes of Jesus. You're changed into his image and you're fathered from above. Isn't that wonderful? Yeah. Hallelujah. So tonight, as we close, I want to just go around and Joy, if you would want to just share some thoughts or prayers or scriptures, whatever you'd like to share before we go tonight and pray. And then Jody, if you have a song or something you want to close with our prayer, go ahead.
Just to echo back what you're saying, I just feel in my heart, just the love of God, just the fact that God loves you out there that is watching this tonight. If there's any doubt in your heart, if you're going through difficult time right now, difficult things going on in your life, please just know that God loves you. He loves you so much. Don't let the things that you're going through make you to question God's love for you. Don't judge God based on what is going on right now, but judge him based on his word. Just believe that he loves you and he will see you through. No matter what you're going through right now, look at this as temporary. The Bible said that this too will pass. It will come and pass. It will not be permanent. God will see you through. You will get through this. He said that he will never leave you nor forsake you. He is there for you. He's going to carry you through. The place that I can think of now is, I think Isaiah 43 said that when you walk through the water, he will be with you. And when you walk through the fire, it will not burn you. God will carry you through whatever you're going through right now. Just hold on to his word. Just hold on to him and know that he will see you through. You are victorious. You are more than a conqueror. You will get through it.
Hallelujah. Go ahead and pray, Joe, if you'd like.
Amen. Father, we just thank you that we are allowed to gather this way, that you are the God of communication, that you have the lines of communication open to us. We thank you for these sisters who are so faithful in their prayers and in their desire to serve you. Father, we ask that you would bless Joy in the ministry that she has through the work of her hands in her day-to-day job as a nurse, Father God, to the friends and family that she ministers to, Father. We just ask that she would know that she's exactly where you've put her, that she's exactly who you need her to be for such a time as this. We thank you for Pastor Linda and for this ministry media that she has, the way that she spends hours just making sure that our voices are heard, that the voice of the Christian woman in the world today is heard in these internet highway, Father God, from Farmington all the way to the nations of the world. Father, we thank you for the work of her hands. We ask that you would strengthen both of them. For Chrissy, who's frustrated because of communication issues and internet issues, we just thank you for her tonight too. For each one in this circle of friends, we just thank you, Father, that you have drawn us together. For Joy, who's not able to be with us tonight, for each one, Father, we just ask that there would be just a great blessing in each of their homes and on their lives. And for those who are watching, those who are being drawn to you, Father, that they would remember that Easter wasn't at all about the bunny, but it was all about your great love for each one of us individually. It was a personal desire that you had to have a relationship with each one of us. We just thank you for that. In Jesus' precious name, we thank you for this time that we've had again. And we just give you all the glory, Father. praise you. Thank you, Father God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Do you have your Rise and Shine song you can sing?
I could.
All right.
Arise, shine, for your light has come. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. Yes, the glory of the Lord rises upon you. Father, we just ask that you would allow each of us to arise and shine in such a way that people would see the works in our lives and they would glorify you. They would know that we are about your business, dear Lord. We just praise you and thank you that we want to be your ambassadors of light in a very dark and sad world. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jody. You know, I love it when you sing because it just brings out the ministry in you. I mean, you are just, you don't even know it, but you need to sing more. You know, I keep telling you that, but you got to sing more.
Thank you for making me do that.
Yeah. Every day you don't go by a day without singing. I'm just saying you're stirring yourself. You stir yourself up every time you sing it. You stir us up every time you sing. So
thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. I'm just excited that I remembered it was Tuesday night. I was already at my 8 o'clock meeting. I'm going into a meeting here now and I had Zoom on and all of a sudden I was like, oh my gosh, there's another Zoom I can be part of. So it was good to see your faces. Joy, yeah. God bless you as you go.
God bless you, Jody. It's good to see you.
Good to see you. Thanks.
And again. I love your voice.
Oh,
yes.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you. Amen. Amen. It's so nice to have you be. We missed hearing you and seeing you. And we missed you too, Joy, tonight. Joy can the other Joy. We have two Joys. So we just pray for Joy tonight. Just bless her and Lord. Amen. Be with her wherever she's at tonight, our other Joy. God, I always say God just filled me with a lot of joy. I have a Joy Nwobu and Joy Farrell, and they're such blessings to me, and Jody, and we got two Jodies. So we just say hi, and Sandy, we just say we miss you all tonight, if those who couldn't be with us. So again, if you have any prayer requests, just let us know. You continue to pray. We'll continue to pray even after we got off the air. God has just been, I pray every day, but God's been really just leading upon me to pray for our nation, to pray for, you know, things that are happening. And I encourage you to fast and pray. You know, there is power in fasting and praying. Jesus said, you know, when you fast and pray, not if you fast and pray. So encourage you, you know, Brother Hagin from Rhema Bible College where I went to school at, always said, live a fasted life. So that's really what I've been doing is just eating less and praying more. So encourage you to do that. And just like Jody said, you know, God just showed up with finances when he told her, you know, she was recommended to fast and pray, and God showed up with the finances. So I just encourage you. That's a great way for breakthrough. Just spend some time dedicated to him and fasting and prayer, and and look up the scriptures, a lot about them in the scripture. So, well, Joy, I appreciate you tonight. Thank you so much. Anything else you want to say in closing?
I appreciate you too. No.
Okay. Well, God bless you all. Thanks everybody for watching, and come back and join us next week for Rise and Shine, 8 o'clock on Tuesday night. And also join us for, if you want to watch any past programs, you can go to lindacross.com and watch the past programs. And if you would like and share my YouTube channel, I need to get 1,000 people on there, subscribers, so that I can do live streaming with my cell phone. So I'm going to be traveling and I'd like to be able to do that. So if you would do that, I appreciate it. And then you can join us on Sunday mornings at Living Hope Church. We're Living Hope CFC is our URL, our website, Living Hope CFC. And we have a live stream on Sunday mornings at 10 a.m. Central Time. So join us for that as well. And again, you can find out more information at lindacross.com as well. So thank you all for watching. God bless you. Have a great night. And thank you, Joy.
Thank you.
You have a great night. All right.
You too.
Thank you so much. All right. God bless. Thank you all for watching. God bless.